بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Through the blessings of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Ahlullah and the Awliya of Allah, we have reached Cairo with Afia. The first mazashif that we are visiting is the blessed Masjid Maqam Barih of a great scholar, Al-Arif Billah, Al-Imam Abu Al-Mawahib Abdul Wahhab Al-Sha'arani الشافعي الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه. ما شاء الله شيخ الإسلام of his age, a great عارف بالله, a great عالم رباني, who had mastered the outward sciences and then at the under the supervision of his شيخ شيخ إمام علي الخواص رضي الله تعالى عنه. الله مفتح لي الله رحمه. He then mastered the inward sciences. Imam عبد الوهاب الشعراني wrote many works from which we still benefit today. For example, Al-Mizan, Al-Kubra, Al-Sha'araniya, MashaAllah, and Lawaqi al-Anwar al-Qudsi fi Bayan al-Uhud al-Muhammadi Lataif al-Minan fi Wujub al-Tahadduth bi Ni'amillahi Lataif al-Minan wal-Akhlaq fi Wujub al-Tahadduth bi Ni'amillahi al-Itlaq, and many great works, Tanbih al-Mukhtarreen, etc., MashaAllah. And he was a great scholar of his age, Arif Billah, Shafi'i scholar, Waliya Kamil, mashallah, we are paying homage and visiting his best Mazar Sharif. And also the Mazar Sharif next to him is the Mazar of Shaykh Nuruddin Ashuni, radiallahu, his Shaykh, who would recite 40,000 salawat upon the Prophet every day. Daily he would recite 40,000 salawat upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, until he reached such a station of closeness to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he would behold the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not just in his dreams but in a wakeful state. Subhanallah. This is Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'arani radiallahu ta'ala, one of the greatest ulama rabbaniyin that the ummah has seen. May Allah subhanahu allow us to benefit from his works. May Allah subhanahu allow us to follow in his footsteps. May Allah accept this ziyarah of ours. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts through his pure heart. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rahmatika ya
arhamar rahimin. Towards the wali. Keep repeating that in your heart. My attention, my focus is towards the heart, and my heart is focused towards the wali of Allah. If you keep this in your mind a couple of times, inshallah, you'll be able to reap the blessings and the tajalliyah that are descending at the dharih. The shrine, the resting places of the awliya, inshaAllah. And whatever dua you want to make, inshaAllah, you can also make a personal dua, inshaAllah.
Al-arifu billah, Sayyidi Ali Nuruddin Ashuni, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the one who established salawat gatherings upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam across the entire Egypt. He is the one who started salawat gatherings. In his gatherings, people would come recite salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they would be blessed to behold the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a dream, and many would also be able to behold the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a wakeful state. This is Shaykh Nuruddin Ashuni radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who was instructed by the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a dream to establish Durood Sharif gatherings, salawat gatherings. He went to Tanta, to the Masjid of Sayyidi Shaykh Ahmad al-Badawi radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and also established salawat gatherings there. And many ulama mention about the barakat and the blessing. He himself would recite 40,000 salawat upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every day, to an extent that he would be able to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a vision, in a wakeful state, and seek knowledge directly from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. It also mentioned about him that whenever Ahlu Misr were afflicted with a calamity, they would turn to him. And as soon as he would raise his hands in making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah would alleviate that calamity and that problem. So make dua at his blessed shrine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alleviates the calamity that has befallen the ummah, especially our Muslim brothers and sisters in Gaza and Palestine. Ya Allah, alleviate the calamities, their problems, their afflictions. And subhanallah, this is an amazing barakah that we receive from the blessed shrine of Imam Nuruddin Ashuni radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that a lesson that we should all take is to continuously recite salawat. salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Subhanallah, this is the blessed maqam dharih al-sharif of al-arifu billah, the one who was directly inspired by knowledge, directly inspired with knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-arifu billah sayyidi al-shaykh Ali al-Khawas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who was the murid and the khalifa of Shaykh Ibrahim al-Matbuli radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and Shaykh Sayyidi Ali al-Khawas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu is the Shaykh, the Murabbi, the Murshid, the one who actually took Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'rani radiyallahu ta'ala to the heights of wilaya. Shaykh Ali al-Khawas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, as Imam al-Sha'rani mentioned, he had a shop and he would sell sesame seed oil, and he would, subhanallah, live a very austere lifestyle, very simple life. So whatever he earned, he gave it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired him with al-ilm al-ladunni. Durul Ghawas, Imam al-Sha'rani has written a book where Imam Ali al-Ghawas, where he asks questions. Imam al-Sha'rani here, remember, is a proficient, erudite scholar of Islam, asking questions to his Shaykh Ali al-Ghawas regarding many intricate sciences of tafsir, of hadith, etc., etc. And subhanallah, this Shaykh ostensibly, apparently, did not study with anyone. Did not go to a madrasa, a university, a jami'ah. Allah subhanahu inspired him with al-ilm al-ladunni. Subhanallah, he was visually impaired, but his basira was so bright that he would be able to answer questions that the ulama of that time were not able to answer. And Imam al-Sha'rani has many books about questions that he asked Shaykh Ali al-Khawas, the great Murshid Murabbi, the way he, mashallah, did the tarbiyah of Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'rani is amazing. We said the first encounter that Imam al-Sha'rani had, Shaykh Ali al-Khawas told him, you must sell all of your books, sell all of the books and give whatever you receive, sadaqah, a sadaqah to the poor and the needy. And then futuhat came, subhanAllah. He's resting here in Cairo in Bab al-Futuh, the door of openings, inshallah. May Allah give us spiritual openings, inshallah, through the barakah of Shaykh Ali al-Khawas radiyallahu ta'ala. Sayyidi, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, we are right in front of Al-Jami' Al-Azhar Al-Sharif, the Al-Azhar Mosque, which also used to be the madrasa where hundreds of students from across the entire globe would come to flock to learn the sacred knowledge, mashallah. This is the beautiful Al-Azhar Mosque that we will be visiting. The many awliya have prayed here. There's Ruwaq al-Hindiya, Ruwaq, different places where the scholars would come, would visit, would study here. Before it was then shifted to Jami' al-Azhar, which is the adjacent building next to it. Alhamdulillah, we are going to visit the Al-Azhar Mosque, where many of the awliya, Ahlullah, have prayed Salah. Inshallah, we will be blessed to pray Namazi, inshallah. May Allah accept. We are right inside the Jami' Al-Azhar al-Sharif, the Grand Al-Azhar Masjid. As you can see, there are many classes that are running right now for Tajweed, for Hifdhul Qur'an al-Kareem, mashallah. You can see many of the students studying with their teachers, revising the Qur'an, studying the Qur'an, inshallah.
اچھا مولانا صاحب یہ دیکھ کے بادشاہ آپ کا ماشاء اللہ ذہن میں آیا کہ ماشاء اللہ سبحان اللہ علم کا سمندر ماشاء اللہ آپ ہے تو ان شاء اللہ آئیں گے ان شاء اللہ
الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله. It is a great honor to be at the feet of one of the greatest Gnostics of Cairo, Sayyidi Ahmad Aidir Abul Barakat radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And it has been mentioned that the name Aidir is because of one of from Ahlul Bayt radiallahu ta'ala anhu, which a caravan came and they were settled here. On that day, Sheikh Ahmad was born. For the nisbah of the Sayyid who came with the kafila, the caravan, they called the son Ahmad Daidi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And his name is Abu al-Barakat, a place of barakah. And as we mentioned, the du'as are accepted at the shrine of Sheikh Ahmad Daidi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And there's also another wazifa they mentioned, whosoever recites Fatiha at the place of Sayyidi Ahmad Adi radiallahu ta'ala anhu abul barakat, and then without talking to anyone goes and pays respects at the shrine of Sayyidi Imam Ali Maqam Sibti Rasul Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhu, makes dua, Allah ta'ala will accept his dua. So this place of ijaba, place of acceptance, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, accept our dua. Allah ta'ala remove calamity from Ahlul Gaza and Philistine and give peace and harmony to the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه بحمده تعالى. We are currently outside the Grand Masjid of one of the queens of Egypt, one of the queens of Ahlul Bayt, Sayyida Tayyiba Abida Sayyidatuna Zainab bint Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, the daughter of Mawla Ali Mushrik Shahada Karrar, and the beloved sister of Imam al-Shahidain, Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. Again, this is one of those beautiful spiritual places where people can find peace and harmony, and where du'as are readily accepted through the sadaqah of Ahlul Bayt, especially Sayyida Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha. May Allah ta'ala fill our hearts with true love of Ahlul Bayt, inshaAllah.
I can be some of your
ادرس نحن اثر ان شاء الله نكس على المجال.
We are currently at the feet of one of the princes of Ahlul Bayt, Sayyiduna wa Mawlana wa Qudwatuna, Sayyiduna Zayd ibn Zainul Abidin radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Sayyiduna Zayd ibn Zainul Abidin radiallahu ta'ala anhu was known for his knowledge, for his piety, for his outer and inward knowledge. And Sayyiduna Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu became shaheed in the month of Safar, in the year 122 AH. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sadaqah of Ahlul Bayt, Sayyidina Zayd al-Shaheed ibn Zayn al-Abidin radiallahu ta'ala an. Allah ta'ala protect the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from all types of harms, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow all of us to be under the shade of the banner of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the company of Rasulullah Ahlul Bayt, and we enter Jannah inshaAllah.
By the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all praise is due to Him who has blessed us to pay visit to and homage to, make ziyarah of the Lady of Egypt, the Queen of Egypt, Sayyida al-Tayyiba al-Tahira al-Nafisa al-Hasaniya radiyallahu ta'ala anha, the great granddaughter of Imam al-Hasan al-Mujtaba radiyallahu ta'ala anha, mashallah, Sayyid Nafisa radiyallahu ta'ala anha. Her maqam Mazar Sharif is one of the most prestigious maqamat, one of the holiest sites in Egypt, where du'as are accepted. She was herself mustajabu da'wat, and she was mustajabu da'wat, and also at the same time, the place where she is resting today, she had completed the entire khatmat of the Quran 7,000 times, more than 7,000 times. Imam al-Shafi'i, the great Imam of the Ahlul Sunnah, Al-Imam al-Mujtahid al-Muttalibi al-Qarashi radiallahu anhu, would very often come to study and learn from Sayyidina Nafisa radiallahu anha. She is one of his great teachers, and he would also frequently seek her du'as whenever he would fall ill. He would send a messenger to ask Sayyidina Nafisa radiallahu anha to make du'a for him. She would raise her hands, and there Imam al-Shafi'i would be immediately cured. And Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'arani rahimahullah mentions in the Tabaqat al-Kubra, with reference to his grand Shaykh, Shaykh Ibrahim al-Matbuli radiallahu ta'ala, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to him in a dream or in a visionary experience and told him that if anyone has any worldly, afterworldly need, dunyawi or ukhrawi, then they should make a mannah, a vow in the name of Sayyidina Nafisa radiallahu ta'ala, even if it's a dirham, that if my objective is fulfilled, I will inshallah give money, sadaqah, to the poor and the needy in the name of Sayyidina Nafisa radiallahu ta'ala anha, and inshaAllah their need will be fulfilled. This is mujarrab, experienced by the Ahlullah, by the ulama. Even people today experience the blessings of Sayyidina Nafisa radiallahu ta'ala anha. May Allah bless us through her blessing, grant us husnul khitam, alleviate the afflictions of the Muslims in Gaza and Palestine, across the entire world. Ya Allah, give us the fahat and the barakat of Sayyida radiallahu.
In the company of Sayyidatuna Zainab radiallahu ta'ala anha, and she stayed here and she passed away peacefully in the city of Al-Qahira. So pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Allah ta'ala elevate her ranks. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala illuminate our hearts through the sadaqah of Sayyidatuna Sakina, and may Allah give us Sakina in this world.
قوي النسب، لكن تجد غاضبا قهوة فهو
وشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون إن الله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله بحمد تعالى. This is صلاة الجمعة at the feet of one of the greatest nasibs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the kutub of the Islamic world, Sayyidina wa qudwatuna wa qa'iduna Sayyidina al-Sharif al-Sayyid Ibrahim al-Suqi radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Such a great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that even after his passing away, millions of Muslims around the world are being blessed with the blessings of this great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praise and maqam where du'as are accepted. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the sadaqah of Sayyid Ibrahim al-Suqi radiallahu ta'ala Allah ta'ala give us all salvation of the world. And Allah Ta'ala protect Ummah, especially the Ahlul Filistin, Ahlul Gaza, through the Sadqa of Awliya Al-Fatiha.
Child is still in the womb of the mother as a fetus, I am able to inform. I know about whether that person is going to be Shaqi or Sa'id, from the blissful, fortunate ones in Jannah, or from the wretched ones, the denizens of hellfire. And he says, not a leaf falls except that I have knowledge concerning it, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inspired me. This is Sayyidina Shaykh Ibrahim al-Busuqi. He has many karamat. One famous karama of his, inshallah, is about the river Nile, when a crocodile had devoured a child. So the mother came crying. Sayyidina Shaykh Ibrahim al-Busuqi radiallahu ta'ala, Sayyidina Shaykh Ibrahim al-Busuqi went to the river Nile and said, whosoever has devoured this child, you must throw up the child. So one crocodile came out to the, up to the surface and then swam to the coast of the River Nile and then threw out that child alive.
Wow.
MashaAllah. They say in Allahu A'lam that what you see in that box is a part of that crocodile. And if you go across to the other side, you will see the blessed imprint of the blessed palm of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the corner there, where there's the green lights. And next to him is the blessed Mazar Sharif of his brother Abu Imran, the brother of Sayyidina Shaykh Ibrahim al-Dusuki radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is also his first Khalifa.
One of his teachers is Sayyidina Imam Ahmad Badawi radiallahu anhu, and he is from the nasal lineage of Imam Hussein radiallahu anhu. The only books or historians that mention, especially in these, the four main Aqdar Awliya. So Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani radiallahu ta'ala, and then Shaykh Ahmad Kamili Fa'i, heard about him in the morning. Sheikh Ibrahim Yusufi and Sheikh Ahmad. When Sheikh Ahmad Badawi radiallahu went to Baghdad, he used to read a lot of books on Osman radiallahu anhu. He himself went to Osman radiallahu anhu and Sheikh Ahmad Ifai and got spiritual opening to the heart from the Ashrafis. And then he was given ijazah to go to Tantab and guide people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he came, and one of his students is the Ibrahim Yusufi. So you can understand how great Hassan Hussein is saying. He's a wali, he's an alim, he's a ifa'i qadri. So he came to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the sadqa of his mentor. Open our hearts.
Amen.
Renew our hearts to the prayers of Sayyidina Shaykh Ahmad Badawi.
وعدد ما ذكرك به خلفك فيما مضى وعدد ما هم ذاكروك به فيما فقر في كل سنة وشهر وجمعة ويوم وليلة وساعة من الساعات وشمس ونفس وكوكب ولمحات من الأبد إلى الأبد أبد الدنيا وأقصر من ذلك لا ينقطع هدى ولا ينقطع أخرى. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد بالليل إذا يغشى صلي على سيدنا محمد.
يا ريكي Yours or mine? Sir? Oh, you got the lead?
The great Mufassir, the great Muhaddith, the great Ashiq of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a well-known name, Imam Jalaluddin As-Suyuti radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He was born in the year 849 AH, and passed away 911 AH. And Allah subhanahu wa, he was born in a family of scholars. His father was a imam, and As-Suyuti is a place, hence As-Suyuti radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And his father told his mother, go and get me a kitab from a library. Now when she went to the library, she was expecting, I mean, she was carrying Imam Suyuti radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In the library, she gave birth to Imam Suyuti radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hence, his name became Ibn al-Kutub, the son of the books. And then later the father came, he became a qadi. Father came to Cairo and he was raised here, where Imam Suyuti radiallahu ta'ala anhu was very young. He started to acquire knowledge and then went to perform Hajj. Okay, and when he drank Zamzam water, so remember the hadith, isn't it, that if you drink Zamzam and you make dua, your duas will be accepted. So Imam Suyuti drank water and said, Ya Allah, give me knowledge of fiqh. La Imam Bulqini radiallahu ta'ala, and give me the knowledge of hadith like Sayyiduna Ibn Hajar Asqalani radiallahu ta'ala. And Allah ta'ala blessed him with immense knowledge, and then he wrote many, many books and famous kitab, which all students of sacred knowledge, they know, Tafsir Jalalain. His one of his teachers, also called Jalaluddin, himself called Jalaluddin, Tafsir Jalalain. Okay, Imam Jalaluddin was only at the age of 17, 18 when he wrote Tafsir Jalalain, the first 15 juz. Okay, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And such an ashiq of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he has seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam wakefulness approximately more than 60 times. Okay, in wakefulness. Okay, as Shaykh of such great rank and maqam, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah ta'ala illuminate our hearts with true love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with ilm hadith, ilm balagha, ilm nahu, ilm sarf, ilm hadith, ilm tafsir, and tazkiyatun nafs, and may Allah ta'ala allow us to be in the company on the day of judgment. Okay, if, even if you can't follow their footsteps, at least the dua we should try and make, Ya Allah, let us be in the company on Yawm Al-Qiyamah so that we can be also be granted Jannah without Hisab or Kitab, inshallah. Al-Fatiha.
يا رحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. With the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are stood at the feet of the great Imam of the four schools of jurisprudence, the Imam of the Shafi'i school, Al-Imam Al-Mujtahid Al-Muttalib Al-Qarashi, Al-Imam Muhammad ibn Idris Al-Shafi'i radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda'ah. Subhanallah, he was a great arif billah, an imam mujtahid, born in Gaza, completed the memorization of the Quran at a very early age, after which his mother took him to Makkah al-Mukarramah and then to the scholar of Darul Hijrah, Imam Malik ibn Anas radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and he had already memorized the Muwatta of Imam Malik radiyallahu ta'ala at a very young age. Imam Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was such a great wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'rani rahimahullah mentions, whenever I visited the blessed maqam, mazar, the blessed darih, the blessed grave of Imam al-Shafi'i radiyallahu ta'ala, I found Sakina descending upon his grave. Sakina, tranquil, all the angels that bring peace and comfort to the hearts and to the minds. So pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alleviates the ranks of this great Imam. For his blessings, Ya Allah, forgive our sins and shortcomings. Grant us ikhlas in all of our endeavors. Accept our du'as, fulfill all of our needs. Give hadhan wafir, a great share of the blessings of Imam al-Shafi'i and the other great awliya to our children and our forthcoming generations. He was Husn al-Khitam upon the kalima La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa
The first masjid we went in the morning, the masjid of Amr ibn As radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who is the sahabi who determined the direction of the Qibla. And when recording the books, approximately 100 ahadith mubarakah in books of the Sihah have been narrated from Sayyidina Uqba ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now, Mawlana Hafiz Ahmad Raza was mentioning narration that he was a farmer and he gave everything to be in the company of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And a well-known narration that when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he veiled himself, left this mundane world, as Uqba bin Amir radiallahu ta'ala was crying. He really wanted to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ummul Mu'min Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha gave Uqba bin Amir a mirror. And Uqba bin Amir, the mu'jiza of the Prophet is such that even the mirror had profound love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once it reflected the image, it kept the image in itself. So when this is a true sign of a lover, that even objects would love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and therefore Sayyiduna Uqba ibn Amir saw the mirror, and instead of his own reflection, he saw the face of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And mashallah, I'll give you another beauty of this maqam. Behind me is where that mirror is placed. Okay, so this is the maqam. Inshallah, we make dua. Allah Ta'ala blesses the blessings of the Sahaba. Remember, no wali, the greatest of the greatest of wali, can never reach the rank of a Sahabi. And these are, you know, the from the group of the greatest Sahaba, al Majma'een. Okay, Ashab al Badr.
Single moment to be veiled from beholding the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam for even a second, the Shaykh Ahmad ibn Atallah Sikandari radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he has written many books on the tasawwuf. He has a famous work called
here for many years, and as we mentioned in the previous books,
سید سجاد کی صدقے میں ساجد رکھ مجھے علم حق دے باقی
سگر ہے نہیں مارے جاتے حشر تک میرے گلے میں پتا تیرا چاند بھی جس پہ حمایت کا ہو بل جا
يا عثمان يا حيدر دفع شر الخلاف يا شبيب
الكبير يا شباب يا سيدني ويا عمر يا عثمان يا حيدر دفع شرق خيرا يا شبير يا شبر يا